Well, let's talk to some of the listeners. Jay, you've been very patient. You're talking with the former Governor Branstad and State Auditor Vaught.
Yeah, hi, Terry. Hi, Dave. I had a question regarding the demographics here in the state of Iowa. A large, if not the largest, part of our population employment is in the either federal, state, or local government sector. A large part of that's in our teaching institutions, which does turn out people with somewhat of an ideology toward liberalism, if not socialism. With that large of a demographic, when you start spouting the numbers in spending, I think you're kind of projecting a narrow wheelhouse. It's an ideology that they're actually supporting, and B, I don't think we articulate what $900 million in debt actually means to us at the kitchen table in the future, and I don't think we do a good job on articulating that message. So, how do you get by the hurdle that in Iowa the perception is that a lot of people look at big government as a good thing? And secondarily, when you start talking about these large in numbers, it really doesn't resonate with most people because the numbers are unimaginable, and we just don't articulate what it really means to them at the kitchen table for them and their families.
Let me build on his question for a second. The governor has accepted early retirement of a bunch of Iowa employees to the point where he wants to rehire 1,100 new ones.
I think that's unconscionable because the whole idea of early retirement was try to reduce the cost, and part of the problem is public employees are paid more than comparable jobs in the private sector.
More. And the highest gap in the country is here in Iowa.
Right. Plus the benefits. And so that's part
of
the problem.
Which are also unsustainable. You have an IPERS fund that's almost $5 billion gap in the future commitments and the ability to pay. And the current crop wouldn't even re-examine the defined benefit package that state employees get that we can't afford either. So what are you prepared to do about some of these things?
Well, first and foremost, since we've had over 2,000 people take early retirement, we should not be replacing 1,100 of them. Maybe there's a few critical positions you need to do, but you shouldn't. Also, we need to change the system that ratchets up people so that they get automatic increases just for every year that they work for state government. So they had these so-called step increases. That's why the senior employees are making so much money, more than twice as much as a new hire in the same position with the same responsibility. So we need to change the whole system of compensation to be more equitable and more fair, more comparable to what it is in the private sector. And we need to reduce the size and cost of government. We need to do it in a very thoughtful way, focused on trying to provide the services in the best and most efficient way possible. I'll give you an example. We talked about the Fisher Commission earlier that came up with the ideas to reform state spending and put the 99% spending limitation and control Medicaid, foster care, indigent defense. One of their ideas that wasn't well received in Iowa was to reduce the costs by having driver's license available at fewer locations. Instead of every county, they would just regionally, you might have to drive 100 miles to get your driver's license renewed. Well, that went over like a lead balloon in rural Iowa.
Is it time to renegotiate or rethink the defined benefit package?
I think it's appropriate for new hires to look at a system like the private sector and like other states are starting to look at a defined contribution system, but it would be for new hires, would not affect those people that are presently employed or those people that are retired. But I think it's not sustainable what we have today, and a lot of states are starting to look at it. Governor Chris Christie in New Jersey and a number of other states are looking at what Illinois and California and New Jersey have is a disaster. The Iowa situation isn't as bad as that, but it's in the long term, it's not sustainable. We need to look at a different approach. The private sector many years ago went to a defined contribution as opposed to a defined benefit system. And there is an advantage to that because if you change jobs, then you can roll that over to an IRA and you still have that retirement money as opposed to the present system where you're basically stuck with the present system and you really are. It's very hard to change jobs. So I think there's some benefits to looking at that for the long term, but it needs to be done in a very thoughtful way. But I wanted to point out, when we dealt with this problem before with regard to the driver's licenses, this is where Kim Reynolds got my attention. Kim Reynolds was the county treasurer, and she was one of the leaders of the county treasurers who came to me and said, we can do it at the county level, and we can do it cheaper and we can do it and make it more convenient. Instead of having a driver's examiner coming once every 2 weeks for a half a day, we can offer this 5 days a week, and we can do it with our present staff. We're already collecting vehicle registration and property taxes, and so the DOT didn't like the idea. They didn't want it turned over to the counties. But what we did is we did a pilot project with 6 counties in southwest Iowa. It worked over so well, we're now doing it in 81 counties, providing better services, and it's being done locally. That's what we need to do. We need to examine the way we deliver services. Some of those things can be done better at the local level. Some better may be consolidated, but we need to look at the most efficient and cost-effective way to deliver services at less cost to the taxpayer. Terry Brand-